If you see some mess behind me, please don't pay attention. My home is in a mess. I don't manage to handle everything these days. Anyway, the other day I was kind of a little lost, not knowing what to do, and a little confused. And I was browsing on internet, searching for something without knowing what I was searching for, actually. And I came across an old, very old video by Jennibellie about... she was talking about an inspiration that she had, and she was calling that her cosmic inspiration. And according to what she was saying, it reminded me a kind of inspiration I had when I was doing my paintings about Jim Morrison. I will try to include some pictures of these paintings. I made many, but I will try to include a few ones here in my video, so you can see. Probably you already saw some of them on my previous videos, but if you didn't, if it's the first time that you arrive here, you will have the opportunity to see a few of them. So I've been painting about Jim Morrison during many years, something like 10 years, something like that. And the inspiration coming from from that was a little weird. I think that I never said how it happened. Actually, I don't know how it happened. I always loved the Doors, but I was not especially a Doors fan. I mean, when I was a child, I was way too young to appreciate the Doors, and later I liked them, but not at the point of buying their music or getting some interest in Jim Morrison, because in my mind Jim Morrison was a drug addict, and I'm not especially a fan of that. So I was not really a fan, and I don't know what happened suddenly. So it was not in a dream like for Mark Hollis and Tok Tok. It was when I was beginning writing my book, my art and craft book, which has been released in France many years ago. I will include the picture of my book also here. You can still find it, not new, used on Amazon.fr and Canada, and maybe US, I'm not sure. You can find it on Fnac also. But it was many years ago, so it's a very old book. I'm not saying that for you to buy it. That's not the point. So I was starting my book, and I was searching for something to say in my introduction, and nothing was coming. It was a book of art and craft, so you imagine that I already made the different parts of the book. But I had to write the introduction, and I didn't know what to write. And I was alone in my home. My ex-husband was working. He was in, I don't remember if he was touring or if he was in a studio working, but he was not there. And I was alone. Yes, just my kids were there, but they were sleeping. It was at night. And I put the TV on. I had the TV in my bedroom in Paris. Here I don't have TV, but there I had a TV. And it was the Oliver Stone's film, The Doors, that I never saw before. And they were playing that film. And I started watching the film. Already began, it was maybe 30% of the film already was passed, and I really arrived almost in the middle of the film. and the voice were in French, what I don't like. I like watching movies in the original voices, but so I look at that, but I just put the images and I cut the sound. I didn't want the sound because I wanted to work on my introduction, and I don't know why I needed some light, something, some animation in front of me. And of course, I started watching the images without the sound at the point I wanted to put the sound on. So I started watching this film without knowing what it was, because I didn't have the program of the TV. And I started being taken in the action and wondering who is this guy. And when I started hearing some songs, I understood that it was The Doors and it was about Jim Morrison. What is funny is that Val Kilmer looks so much like Jim Morrison in this film that at a point I was wondering if it was Jim Morrison or an actor. At the beginning I was not sure. After, of course, I understood. I was really stupid. Anyway, and I started watching this film, and at the end I was kind of stunned, because it's not at all how I was imagining Jim Morrison and the story of The Doors. I was a little confused by this film, and especially because it was in French, so not good. At the end of the film, I was wondering, because after his death, we can see in the film him still singing in the studio, and I was like, how they can film him if he died? I didn't understand it was an actor. Anyway, then I understood. I thought, it must not be him. But in the film, Val Kilmer looks a lot like Jim Morrison, so it's very confusing if you don't know what it is about. I thought it was a documentary, a kind of documentary. Anyway, and the next day I couldn't stop thinking about this film, and I started looking about Jim Morrison and everything. And then, maybe, I think it was about 10 days later, what they do, there is a specific channel in France, when first they play the film in French, and then several days later they play it again, later in the evening, but in the original language. That's what they were doing then. So it was something like 1997. Something like that, yes, 1997. And 10 days later, I was still working on my introduction, still confused, and alone again. I put the TV on again, and it was the same film, but in English, in American, and it was the very beginning of the film, so I thought, oh, okay, this time I'm going to watch this movie, and from the beginning, and in English, it's much better. And I was stunned by the film. I was really very overwhelmed and confused, and really I wanted to know more about Jim Morrison. Even though he's shown like a crazy guy in the film, it's not really at his advantage, and a lot of things, now I know that a lot of things in this film are false, but it interested me enough to attract my attention about Jim Morrison. So I started searching about him on internet, of course, and I went on his grave, which was very close to where I used to live. It was like a 3 metro station. I could go by foot. It was about half an hour by foot to go to his grave. So I did that very often. I went on his grave, which is weird for me because I never go in cemeteries. That's really not my thing. So I went there, and I also saw where he died, where he's supposed to have died. We are not sure, Rue Beautreilly. And basically, I was really living between the both. I was living between the place where he was supposed to die and the place where he was buried. And I had not been painting during many years. When I was a child, I was oil painting. I was making some paintings here and there, but not always, not very often. And suddenly, I don't know what happened. I took a canvas and I started painting and painting and painting and painting and painting, and I couldn't stop painting. And I've been painting during years, and I was actually kind of representing Jim Morrison's poetry or the lyrics in his songs. It was more about the lyrics than about the music. I was listening to his music by painting, but I was more carried by the lyrics. But something really weird happened then. It's that I didn't care what people could think about my paintings, because I didn't feel really personally involved in my paintings. I had the feeling that someone was guiding my hand. I was just holding the brush, but it was something which was coming through me and that I was translating on a canvas. And I couldn't explain that. So when people were coming in my home, and some people liked what I was doing, some people thought that I was completely crazy, some people asked me what did I smoke before painting that. And I smoked nothing. I don't take drugs, I don't drink, I don't do anything. And maybe I was drinking coffee then, but it's basically what I was doing the most, you know. So now I drink tea because I can't drink coffee anymore. But, you know, it was funny because people were like, wow, what is that? And I knew before starting a painting, I knew what I had to paint. And I was painting and painting and painting, and I couldn't stop, and all the paintings were coming one after the other, and it was incredible. I don't know how many paintings I made. I have so many. I sold some, not a lot, but I sold a few of them. But I still have a lot remaining. Some people wanted to buy some of them here, but they didn't want to give me the price I wanted, and I want to sell them to a certain price because I consider that they have a lot of value, not because I'm the painter, I'm not famous, I have no value on the art market, you know, but because I have the feeling that they have another kind of value. So I couldn't explain that. I had this inspiration coming from the lyrics, probably the music, but not only, like something else. I was literally carried by something, and it was out of my control. When I was painting, I was feeling like if I was somewhere else. At a point, I was painting a painting that I called it Strange Days, like the song, and it has the shape a little like a door, the frame. And at a point I was so much in my painting that I had the feeling to be inside the painting, and suddenly the phone rang. And I was like, how am I going to get out of my painting to go and answer? And actually, I think that it's my husband, my ex-husband, who went to answer the phone, because I was so much in my inspiration. It was kind of a meditation, or I don't know what it was. And all that stopped when my ex-husband left. My inspiration gone. Nothing. It's like if I lost the contact with I don't know what. That's why I thought that maybe this inspiration was coming from my ex-husband, And because he was not there anymore, I couldn't be in contact with this thing. What was strange is that at that period, everywhere I was going, I could hear some Doors music. Everywhere. I could hear some Doors music, or I could see an image of the Doors, or an image of Jim Morrison, or someone talking to me about the Doors without knowing that I was interested in the Doors. It was like in my building, passing, I was at the sixth floor without elevator, passing in the stairs, and a neighbor playing the Doors. Neighbor, brand new, just arrived, I didn't know they liked the Doors, playing the Doors. Going in the street, a musician playing the Doors. Going in the metro, a musician playing the Doors. Coming in Los Angeles, going in a Japanese restaurant, going to the toilets, in the toilets, playing the Doors. And you know, it can be completely randomly happening, you know, it's possible, of course, it's possible. But when it's every day, every day, every day, you start wondering. I precise that I don't believe in weird things. I don't believe in ghosts or spirits or things like that. It's not my thing, you know. I don't believe in these things. But at that period, I was really wondering, and I was feeling like if I was in a mission that I had to do all these paintings as fast as possible. And then I moved to LA. Jim Morrison is coming from here, or was coming from here, you know. All this part of my life was really strange. But the inspiration was fabulous because I didn't have to make any effort about thinking what I was going to do. It was just coming like that. And I didn't have to make any effort about the technique, if I was painting well or not, if people were going to like it or not. I didn't care about that because I knew that what I was doing was right. I didn't think about what I was going to do. The image was coming here, and I was doing here, and that was it. And people like it, good. People don't like it, good. Who cares? I had some people saying it sucks, it's such a big that it's not some art or things like that. And I was kind of laughing inside because I was like, I don't care anyway, it's not my idea, you know. I didn't think that, I just did. And I know that what I did is probably very good. The weirdest thing that I had, I made a drawing for Soul Kitchen, my painting Soul Kitchen. Soul Kitchen was the name of a restaurant which was used to be on Main Street in Santa Monica. So on Main Street, almost near the beach, not far from the beach. And before going to Los Angeles, I never went to Los Angeles before, I made the drawing of how I was seeing Soul Kitchen. I still have the drawing somewhere. And when we came in vacation in Los Angeles, I wanted to see where Soul Kitchen used to be. And when I arrived, now it's surf. Last time I went, it was a surf store. But the building is still there. And what I drew was exactly the building that I saw when I went there. So even I drew a lamp, you know, a street lamp. It was there. So that frightened me because I thought, whoa, that is becoming a little weird. I don't like that, you know. That is something which a little scared me. I don't like to think that I have this kind of weird power. But anyway, it's not the case anymore. I saw Jim Morrison not a long time ago. I saw a picture of him. I went at CVS and I arrived in the magazine section, and I never buy magazines, actually, very rarely. I think I was searching for something else, but I arrived there and boom, picture of Jim Morrison just in front of me, and I thought it has been a long time that it didn't happen, you know. So that was really strange. But the one thing wonderful that I remember of that period is that amazing inspiration, cosmic inspiration, as Jennibellie calls it, like something you don't even have to think, it's coming to you, and you paint, you draw fast, and it's coming, and you don't even wonder if it's going to be good or bad, because you know that that is what you have to do. Whatever the result, that's what you have to do. So when my ex-husband left, everything was gone. Contact disappeared. Inspiration disappeared. Mojo, no more Mojo Risin in my mind. It came back when I had this dream about Tok Tok and Mark Hollis. But it's quite different. The inspiration came back, but not by the same way. I mean, when I paint about Mark Hollis, I'm thinking what I must put on the painting. I don't have the feeling that it comes just like that. I really have the feeling that it's my idea and I decide what I put on the painting. So it's a little more difficult. It's also different because Mark Hollis is alive, so I'm really afraid not to be good enough to be not to compete, but I must be good enough because he's really good. He's really, you know, here. But I was also thinking, you know, I love all his albums, and I think there is not one album that I don't like. Of course, I have some, I can't even say that I have some favorite ones. I love them all for different reasons. However, I was wondering if Spirit of Eden, his album that he made just after The Color of Spring, not just, but 2 years after The Color of Spring, or 1 year, I don't know. It was released 2 years after, but maybe he started doing it 1 year after. I'm wondering if it's not this kind of inspiration, because seriously, when I listen to Spirit of Eden, I have the feeling that there is something sacred in it, something very special, like if he was inspired by something coming from I don't know where, I don't know. And that is why it couldn't be changed. It couldn't be improved or made more commercial, or I think that he wanted to find something new, different to do, and he probably wanted to go in another direction because he couldn't continue to do something like The Color of Spring. But really, I have the feeling that there is something more in this album. So I was wondering the other night if Spirit of Eden was his cosmic inspiration, if it came to him like that, like for my paintings about Jim Morrison, or like Jennibellie's cosmic inspiration and things like that. You know, it was very pleasant to see this video by Jennibellie the other day, because I thought it was happening only to me, And I was wondering if it was normal. But now that I see that other people are talking about this kind of inspiration, I'm thinking that it's normal. It's a very special inspiration. And I think that probably it arrives when we are maybe very focused on something, or when we really need to go deeper in our art. Or I would like to get that back. Not about Jim Morrison, but I mean to get back this kind of strong inspiration. I probably don't manage to reach it here because my situation is not enough stabilized. It's too confusing to live in the US when I'm French, and there is this immigration issue all the time, issue all the time, and it doesn't allow me to really relax completely. That's probably why I feel that something is missing here. Probably. I don't know. I managed to have bits and bobs here. For example, when I painted Tomorrow started at a point, when I was painting the dancers, I had this kind of moment. But it's too rare. It's very difficult to focus really and to relax and to be in this state of incredible inspiration. But it will come back, probably, by another way. So I didn't start my new painting yet because I didn't want to associate that painting to my father's death. I wanted to let pass a few days before starting this painting. But I think that I'm going to start it soon, because time is passing fast and I really need and want to do it. Okay, a lot of rambling. I'm sorry. I wanted to talk about that. If you are an artist and if something like that happened to you, call that as you want. Cosmic inspiration, mojo. I don't know how to say that. A sacred inspiration, a sacred feeling, a form of meditation while painting. I don't know. It's a higher state of our mind. I suppose we are in a higher state, but I don't know how we call that because I'm not... I don't know much about that. I just experienced it, but I don't know how we are supposed to call it. If you want to do any comment on the subject, I'm very interested about what you lived and how it happened for you. So don't hesitate. Do it. Write a comment and I will read it and I will answer. Okay, I see you very soon. Bye bye.